what's been significant to us, and we talk about it a lot, is we're participating in the change of the country.
The big, big shifts that are happening within Ayala is that we're really managing to reach a much, much broader segment of the population.
How would you describe 2018?
Mariana, I think what's been really exciting within the group is just the momentum over the last 5 or 6 years. We've never seen Ayala grow this fast. And I think I was looking at the numbers, it's a 24% compounded annual growth over the last 6 years, which has never been seen in the history of the company. And I think that's what I find truly exciting. And we can see throughout the group that everyone's really fired up.
And any key highlights from the BUs that come to mind when you think about, you know, the past 5 years
Well, building on what Fernando said, that momentum has really taken place across all industries, but whole new sectors are being transformed by the work that Ayala Land has done. In the telecom side, I like to think that we've really made a big difference to the growth of the BPO industry by supplying all the services that they need. And at the same time, the company itself has moved to a new position on the mobile front. On the energy front, Fernando, there have been some very big wins on that front
as
well.
Yeah, no, I think the most exciting is in the area of renewables, and not just limited to the Philippines, but we built the first wind farm in Indonesia, which is incredible. And we're looking at very exciting projects in Australia, Vietnam. But yes, I think the second point that I'd say, the big, big shifts that are happening within Ayala is that I think if you look across the group, whether it's Ayala Land, whether it's Globe, whether it's BPI, really we're going for the demographic of the country and the people that need the services most. And I think what's become clear is that as long as you can give it in an affordable price, then it's something that really is a gap in the market that we can fill.
On that front, you're so right, Fernando. I mean, you take a bank like BPI. I mean, for many, many years, BPI is a well-respected bank. But for the first time in a long time, it's beginning to touch micro-industries, medium-sized loans. It formalized Banco, which is a bank that's touching base with customers at a whole different income level, different price level, and enabled them to enter the banking industry in a much more formal way, something that had not happened before. Even in Ayala Land, you're touching base at low to medium income housing that I guess traditionally we had not touched. In fact, it's the fastest growing segment in Ayala.
Not just that, we're also looking at different types of living spaces for, I guess, individuals, young people that are coming into the city.
Transitional,
yeah. They're more dorm-like, they're more affordable so that they don't have to commute that many hours a day. I was going to mention though on the issue of the bank that it's just shocking that only about 30% of the country is part of the banking system. And so it's really nice to see BPI moving in such a significant way in that direction, but also Globe through fintech, which I think is very new to all of us, and is showing really that technology can do incredible things for inclusion.
All of it is harnessing and engaging with the needs of the country and deploying capital in ways that keep the country progressing and moving forward. And that's something that I think excites us. It excites our executive team and really, I think, makes the executive team and the employees of Ayala proud, I guess, that we're contributing to a country that's growing.